A very good morning, dear students. I hope you all are fine. So in today's session, we are continuing with marketing part A, chapter 1, communication skill exercise part. In chapter 1, we are having total session 1 to 7. In today's lecture, we are going to continue with session 1 to 4, back exercise. So let's start now. Session 1. First question is, that is MCQ based, multiple choice question. Which of the following is not an element of communication within the communication process cycle? Options are given: channel, receiver, sender and time. Time is not the attribute of communication process, because we include sender, receiver, channel, or we can include message and we can include feedback, but time is not any communication process cycle. Next is, you need to apply leave at work. Which method of communication will you use? Options are email, poster, newsletter and blog. We will use the email method to apply for a leave. Third one, by which action can sender send their messages? Options are gestures, speaking, reading and writing. A sender can send the message by reading their messages. A sender can transfer the message by reading. Next is, make a chart highlighting all the methods of communication. There are so many methods of communication, like face to face, email, notice, poster, business meeting. So what is face to face communication? In which there is nothing better than face to face communication. It's the best medium when we are sitting in front of each other. It helps the message to understood very clearly and very faster. It is a quick method, and since body language can be seen in this case. And email, it can be used to communicate quickly with one or many individuals on same time on various locations. We can transfer email to a number of people on same time. It offers the flexibility, convenience and low cost. Third one is notice and posters. Notice and posters, it is an effective when the same message has to go out to a large group of people. It means we are spreading the message in a community. We are spreading the message in a society. So generally used where email communication may not be effective. For example, change in lunch time for factory working hours. Or XYZ clothing will remain closed for customer on that day. This is in the form of notice or poster. Next is business meeting. Communication during business meeting at one organization are generally addressed to a group of people. When we are taking about business meeting, it means number of person are more. It can be related to the business, it can be related to the management, or it can be related to the organizational decisions. Next question, identify the different communication elements. There are total 5 elements that are included in a communication cyclic process. One is sender, second message, third channel, fourth one receiver, and fifth one is feedback. Sender is the person that will start the communication, and message is the information that the sender want to convey to the receiver, and channel is the medium by which information is being sent, and the receiver is the person who will receive the message that is sent from sender's side, and feedback is the concept of receiver, in which a receiver will acknowledge about the message and it will respond. Either it is positive, either it is negative. Without feedback, there is no communication process completed. Explain the communication process along with its elements. Communication process. What is communication process? Now see, there is a sender and there is a recipient. Sender will send the information or it will provide the input. So for that, they can use the method of speaking, writing, graphics, video or audio method. So before sending, sender will encode the message. Encoding means to say coding is done on the sender side, and at receiver side it will decode the message again. So sender will encode the message, message will go to the specific channel, and that channel will use the message transformation and it will send it to the receiver side. Before getting it receiver, receiver will decode it and receive it, and after receiving, the person who got the message that will convey their feedback. What is the feedback about the message? That is in the form of feedback. Like see the message. Communication starts with the sender side. Sender sends a message. A channel is used to transfer the message. Message is received by the receiver and receiver reply to the sender. This is the communication process that is followed in 5 steps. Next is session 2, MCQ based question it is. Which of the following is an example of oral communication? Options are newspaper, letter, phone calls and email. Phone call is the method of communication that will work as a oral communication in which speaking will work. So it is the answer phone calls. What are the types of words we should use for verbal communication? We can use the simple word for verbal communication. It should be not technical, it should not be jargons, it should not be acronyms. Why do we use the emails? So 4 options are there: to communicate with many people on the same time, to share documents and files, to talk to each other in a real time, or to keep a record of communication. Here 2 points are fine. First one is to communicate with many people at same time, and second to share documents and files. So 2 answers are there. Next is subjective type question. List the different types of verbal communication. Verbal it means to say that is either in speaking, that is either in written form. So types of communication, first is interpersonal. It means this communication take place between 2 person. It's a one-to-one conversation. It means one is sender and one is receiver. For example, a manager discuss the performance with an employee. 2 friends are discussing about homework. 2 people talking to each other or phone calls or video call. And written communication, this form of communication involves writing words. It can be either letter, circular, report, manual, SMS or social media. And it can be between 2 or more people. And a manager writing an appreciation email to an employee or writing a letter to grandmother inquiring about their health. So this is the type of written communication. And small group communication, that is between 8 to 10 people. This type of communication takes place when there are more than 2 people involved. Each participant can interact and converse with rest. For example, press conference, board meeting, team meeting, 10 to 20 people are involved in this type of communication. And one is a large group of communication, that is known as public speaking. Next is list the advantages and disadvantages of verbal communication. Why we are using the verbal communication? There are some advantages. It is an easy method of communication by which you can exchange idea by speaking what you want and you can get a quick response. You will find out the same feedback on same time. Verbal communication also helps to enable you to changing your interaction as per person response. It means if you are interacting with some other person, you can change your reaction, you can change your interaction. And what is the disadvantage of verbal communication? Verbal communication depend upon writing or spoken word. And sometimes the meaning can be confusing or it's very difficult to understand if the right words are not used in communication process. Session 3, MCQ based. Which of these is a positive facial expression? Options are frowning while concentrating, maintaining eye contact, smiling continuously, rolling up your eyes. So good positive expression, that is maintaining the eye contact. So if someone is talking, someone is speaking. What does an upright, it means straight body posture convey or show? If you are sitting straight, what it shows? Pride, professionalism, confidence or humility. It represents that you are confident about your view. It means you are sitting in a confident way if you are sitting straight. Which of these is not an appropriate non-verbal communication at working time? Keeping hand in pockets while talking, talking at moderate speed, sitting straight, tilting head a bit to listen. The answer is keeping hand in pockets while talking. When you are talking with someone, you should not keep your hands in pockets. It is not a good type of verbal communication process. Next is, which of the following statement is true about communication? One is 50% of our communication is non-verbal. 20% communication is done using body movements, face or arms. 5% is done using voice, tone and pose. And 7% is done using words. So the answer that is true, only 7% communication is done using words, rest is done by non-verbal method. Next is put a cross mark against the action below, which are the example of bad non-verbal communication. Laughing during formal communication, it's not good, so it is negative. Scratching head, it is also negative. Smiling when speaking to a friend, it is a positive expression. Nodding when you agree with someone, yes, when you are nodding, it means you are listening, it is positive. Standing state, it is also positive sense. Yawning while listening, it's a negative. When you are listening to someone, you don't yawn on that time. Sitting state, positive. Maintaining eye contact while speaking, it is also a positive expression. And beating nails, it is negative. When you start beating nails, if somebody is speaking in front of you, it is a negative expression. Firm handshake, it is a positive expression. Clenching jaws, it is negative. And looking away when someone is speaking to you, it is a negative expression. If someone is talking to you and you are looking somewhere else, it is a negative. And intense stares, it is also a negative expression. Now question is, draw any 5 signs used for visual communication. Which types of symbols are used for visual communication? These are the symbols like no parking zone, no entry, danger warning, radiation, CCTV camera and mobile phone. You can take any 5. Visual matrices that are represented by a graphics form. Explain nonverbal and visual communication and their importance. So nonverbal communication, it is a expression or exchange of information or message without speaking or without writing any word. It can be performed by gestures, postures or face-to-face expression. So what are the importance of nonverbal communication? Our message becomes more effective if we use the right gesture while communicating. If we know about nonverbal communication, we can understand our audience reaction. We can find out the reaction on the same time, audience is satisfied or not. And we can adjust our interaction accordingly. Using the right gesture and posture, it is a sign of professionalism and etiquettes. And if verbal communication are obstructed by noise or distance, when we can use our hand movement to exchange the message. For example, placing a finger on lips indicates that the need for silence, while nodding the head is the same as typing, speaking yes. And visual communication, it proves to be effective since it involves interchanging message only through images. We can exchange message through images and it is a costly communication. Cost is more either than verbal and non-verbal communication. And what are the importance of visual communication? You don't need to know any particular language for understanding it. It is simple and remain constant. It will be fixed everywhere. It means if different places, same word is kept, it means meaning of word is same. Next question, identify different types of nonverbal communication. So we can use facial expression, postures, gestures, or touch, space, eye contact, and paralanguage. So first one is facial expression. That can be in the form of happiness, sadness, anger, surprise, fear. Like smile when you are meeting to someone. Keep your face relaxed. Match with your expression with your words and nod while listening. Next is posture. Posture shows your confidence level and feelings. For example, a straight body posture shows confidence, while a slumped posture is a sign of weakness. Like keep your shoulders straight and body relaxed. Sit straight while resting your hands and feet in a relaxed position. Or while standing, keep your hand on by your sides. And what are the gestures or body language? Gestures include body movements that express an idea or meanings. For example, raising a hand in the class, it represents to ask a question. Beating nails when you are nervous. So keep your hands open. Avoid pointing your finger at people and tilt your head a bit to show that you are attentive or you are listening to the speaker. And touch represents the relationship. We communicate a great deal through touch. For example, a firm handshake to display confidence and pat on the back to encourage someone. Like shake hands firmly while meeting someone. Avoid other touch gesture during formal communication. And space is a distance gap between two people. Space is the physical distance between two people. The space between the two person while communicating generally depend upon the intimacy or closeness. How much closer they are. There is a huge space between a boss and an employee. Maintain proper space depending upon the relationship, which could be formal or informal, or the closeness with the person with whom you are talking. And eye contact, the way we look at someone can communicate a lot. So eye contact shows that we are paying attention to the person. We are listening to the person. It is the concept of eye contact. It means look directly at the person who is speaking. Avoid staring, keep a relaxed look, maintain eye contact. These are the symbols for eye contact. Next is paralanguage. Paralanguage means to say, whenever you are speaking, your tone should be match, your volume should be match. So how we speak affect our communication and include the tone, speed and volume of our voice. For example, talking fast may show happiness. Excitement or nervousness while speaking slow may show seriousness and sadness. So always use a suitable tone and volume. Maintain a moderate speed while talking with someone. Next is session 4. Session 4, question 1. Which of these are the example of positive feedback? First is excellent. Your work has improved. Second, I noticed your dedication toward the project. You are always doing it in a wrong way. All of the above. So the first one, excellent. Your work has improved. It means it is a positive feedback about an employee of company. Second, which of these are the example of negative feedback? Options are, I hate to tell you that, but your drawing skills are very poor. Second, you can surely improve your drawing. And this is a good drawing, but you can do better. Or none of these. The most negative feedback, that is, I hate to tell you this, but your drawing skills are very poor. Third one, which of the following are effective components of good feedback? Detailed and time-consuming, direct and honest, specific and opinion-based. Always your feedback should be specific. It should be specific to the topic. Next is identify how and when to give feedback. There is a sufficient time to give feedback. Feedback, if shared properly, it can help the reinforce exciting strength and increase the recipient ability to rectify the error. Basically, feedback represents where we are lacking, what are the problems. So if we are giving the feedback on right time to the right person, it can improve in a good way. It can have a long-term effect in a managing and achieving the goals. So a good feedback can have some points like it should be specific, timely, polite, and offering continuous support. Avoid general comments. Specifically to say, avoid any general comment. Try to include example to clarify your statement. Second, timely. Being prompt is the key. Feedback loses its impact if delayed for too long. It should be on the right time. If we are getting late, it means there is no sense. Polite. When it is important to share feedback, the recipient should not feel offended by the language of the feedback. And offering continuous support. Feedback sharing should be a continuous process. After offering feedback, let recipient know you are available for support only. And the last question of session 4, that is, explain the importance of feedback. There are so many importance. The first one importance, that is used as effective feedback, it validates the effective listening. Before discussing the importance, We need to tell that feedback is the last step, that is known as final step of communication cyclic process. Without completion of this step, feedback, a communication is not completed. So why feedback is important? First one, it validates effective listening. The person providing the feedback knows they have been understood and their feedback provides some values. It motivates. Feedback can motivate people to build better relationship and continue the good work that is being appreciated. And it's always there. Every time you speak to a person, we communicate feedback. So it's impossible not to provide one. It's always there. Fourth one, it boosts learning. We will learn more. Feedback is an important to remain focused on the goal, plan better, and well improve products and services. And last point, it improves the performance. Feedback always helps to improve the performance in a better way. We can take better decision to improve and increase the performance of company. So this is all about the session 1 to 4 of exercise part, lesson 1 or chapter 1 you can speak, communication skills. In next video, we will meet with next exercise part, session 5 to 7. Dear students, if you are facing any problem, you can contact me on my WhatsApp number. It's 999-111-8890. Thank you. Have a nice day for this session. Thank you so much.